Hello guys, welcome to my channel Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today I am going to discuss about design of square and flat key. But first I need to add on one of the type of key which I have forgotten to tell you. This is the Kennedy key, which is basically used for heavy duty application. What are the basic difference between different types of key, which I have been discussed in earlier videos. In this key, we basically use more than one key in the shaft or keyways or hub. As I have written here, it consists of two square key as shown in the figure, which is placed from this axis. Apart from 45 degree is the Kennedy key diagram, and its basic application is for heavy duty application, because some key, square key, feather key are basically used for light or medium duty application. For heavy duty application we can use Kennedy key. So moving on further, design procedure or design of a square and flat key. First, I am assuming here one key which has its width of B, small b, height of key is H, which is vertically, and suppose the torque which is transmitted to the shaft is M in subscript T. P is the force on a key which is in the direction from left to right here, as shown here, which is in plane AC. This point is A and this point is C. Because the torque is clockwise, so the key, the force on key will be also from left to right in this direction. This is the force direction. So from figure we can observe that the P on a left AC surface or plane AC, it is equal to opposite reaction P on the right side for equilibrium condition. Without that, the key cannot transmit this torque to its hub. So as you seen here, the P, both the P's are not in the same plane. So due to that, if suppose they are not same plane, so the key will roll in this particular section. So to balance out, we basically considering P dash in this plane from top and bottom for equilibrium condition. Because suppose this P dash will not act here, then this P will act as a moment and the component key will roll in this section. So suppose I wanted to calculate the force acting on the key with respect to torque. Here small d is the diameter of the shaft from here to here. So we know that torque is equal to force to perpendicular distance. Distance will be d by 2. So force P will be equal to mt by d by 2. Simplifying this equation, we achieve 2 mt by d. Load is equal to 2 mt by d. So to design the square and flat key is on the basis of two ways. First will be failure due to, or the we can say that the component key can fail with respect to shear and crushing. Crushing will be occur due to hub load, and the shearing will occur due to this force P. First considering failure due to shearing stress, so we know that tau is equal to load upon area. So load area will be resisting area. Here the resisting area will be AB, this plane. This plane will shear out. So due to that, we consider area of AB plane. So AB plane has a width B, and the shear will take place along this length. This is the length of key. So P by B into L. So we achieve tau is equal to load upon B into A. Area will be width into length. Putting this value load is equal to 2 mt by d, here tau is equal to be achieved 2 mt dbl. Okay. This is the shear stress relation for this key condition, square or flat key condition. Here I am currently not considering this stress is for only flat key or square key. Further we can consider B and H value for calculation simplification. Currently I am only describing the failure criteria for shear stress and for crushing stress. So further failure, next consideration is failure due to crushing stress. To calculate crushing stress, stress is equal to load by area, further considering. So the crushing will occur on the height section or throughout the length, because here the key is mounted half on the shaft and half the section is outside of the shaft. Here I am assuming that AC is approximately equal to BD, approximately equal to H by 2. It means this AC section is approximately equal to BD is equal to approximately H by 2. It means half of this height of key is mounted on the shaft, inside the shaft, or half of the section is outside the shaft, which is mounted on hub, which is mounted on hub. So failure will occur in half of the section of the height of the key. So area will be H by 2 along the length. This crushing will occur. So H by 2 into L will be the resisting area. So sigma is equal to load upon area. Simplifying this equation, 2PHL we achieve. Putting this relation, load is equal to 2 mt by d, we achieve 4 mt dhl is equal to sigma c. So this is the basic relation of crushing stress and shear stress. Further, for further simplification, suppose we know the key is square type key. So we know that for a square key, height and width is equal, B is equal to H. So putting this B is equal to H in this crushing stress equation, we get 4 mt by dBl. Taking 2 outside from this equation, we seen that similarity between these two terms, 2 mt by dBl. So 2 multiplied by tau, we can write it as a sigma c is equal to 2 pi times of tau. From this relation we can say that the crushing stress is 2 times of shear stress for square key, or we can say that crushing stress is more than shear stress in the square key. Okay. I hope you like this video. If you have any query related to this topic, please write down in the comment box. Kindly subscribe my channel and press bell icon adjacent to subscription button. Thank you.